Diaz going up. Going to
finish him right here, right now.
Tremendous pressure by Nate Diaz.
We should always be ready to fight everybody on our worst day.
Every day, the Diamond Warrior.
I've been here 40 years, fighting, still killing.
I want to be involved in real fights.
Right.
Because I'm a real martial artist, and I want to fight real martial artists.
I expect to have to dig deep. I just know I can trust myself.
Dustin Poirier glass knockout!
Oh my gosh, he does it!
The UFC is trying to book one of the highest profile non-title fights possible. The collision of two stars that have victories over the notorious Conor McGregor, Dustin Poirier against Nate Diaz. This fight was meant to happen all the way back in 2018 at UFC 230, but fell apart for some controversial reasons. The official statement says that Poirier pulled out due to an injury, but the Diamond has debunked that several times since then. Here's what Dustin had to say on the matter. Regardless, this is a fight both men want and definitely a matchup to look forward to. So without further ado, we here at Athlete Central are here to tell you everything you need to know about it in this Ultimate Fight Breakdown.
Nate Diaz.
You guys can skip to the attributes section if you want to see the breakdown. Let's start off with the Stockton gangster Nate Diaz. The fan favorite has deprived bloodthirsty fight fans of his appearances in recent years, going on a 3-year hiatus following his duology with Conor McGregor. Nevertheless, those are his highest profile fights, so we'll break them down. His call-out of the Notorious One following his victory over Michael Johnson prompted the UFC to book him as a short-notice replacement for Rafael Dos Anjos after his title fight with Conor fell apart because of a foot injury.
My foot was a balloon. My foot was a balloon. You want to see it? Turn him in. My foot was a balloon.
So the Stockton gangster lived up to his name and stepped up to face McGregor on a mere 11 days' notice. McGregor came out in typical fashion, trying to finish Diaz with powerful shots in round one. The energy expended in the opening round was too much, and Diaz is notoriously known for his chin, so he was able to eat the Irishman's shots without a problem. In round two, an exhausted McGregor was not defending as well, leading to Nate rocking him multiple times to the point where the striker Conor shot for a takedown against the BJJ black belt. The outcome was then inevitable as Nate secured the rear naked choke and finished the fight, later delivering the famous line.
And then all of a sudden he's shooting for a takedown. Yeah. And I'm like, oh, you're a wrestler now. You're a wrestler. I remember I'm the black belt in jiu-jitsu, and you're shooting on me now? So me and you know that this is a wrap.
Hey. 5 months later, the highly anticipated rematch took place at UFC 202, breaking the pay-per-view record the first fight had set, which would not be broken until Khabib faced McGregor at UFC 229. This time, the fight went the distance, with Conor winning rounds 1, 2, and 4, and Diaz taking 2 and 5 in a closely contested fight. Despite Nate calling it a robbery, most experts and fight fans agree with the result, with 65.5% of fans thinking Conor won the fight. After his 3-year break, Nate came back to face the man on the cover of Wheaties, Anthony Showtime Pettis, at UFC 241 in 2019. Diaz showed that he still got it, beating him in a dominant unanimous decision victory. Any questions about ring rust because of inactivity were answered convincingly. Diaz was officially back in the game. Nate returned to headlining pay-per-views after that fight, facing off against Jorge Masvidal at UFC 244 for a belt made specifically for him, the BMF belt. This event was massive. The UFC stacked this card to the gills with fights like Till vs. Gastelum, Wonderboy vs. Luque, and stars like Derek Lewis and Kevin Lee also featuring. The cherry on top of the cake is the fact that the UFC got The Rock to wrap the belt around the winner's waist. The fight ended in an anticlimactic way, with a doctor stopping it because of a cut on Diaz at the end of the third round. However, Jorge was completely dominating Nate for the duration of the fight, showing off his impeccable striking in the fight that really catapulted him to stardom. Diaz fans still claim that Nate could have turned things around in the later rounds, as he is known for his incredible cardio and also considering what happened in his next fight against Leon Edwards. They were paired up in UFC 263 in the first ever non-title 5-round fight that wasn't headlining, yet again made especially for Nate Diaz. Leon Edwards showed why he is an elite in that matchup, but Rocky, ironically, got rocked in the 5th round when Diaz fired off a combination in round 5 that stunned the Brit. Instead of going for the finish in a fight he was clearly losing, Nate chose to taunt him in typical Diaz fashion, leading to a unanimous decision loss.
Dustin Poirier.
Dustin has been way more active these past few years, getting 13 fights in the same amount of time that it took Nate to compete 5 times. Dustin scored 3 spectacular KOs against Eddie Alvarez, Justin Gaethje, and common foe Anthony Pettis. That earned him an interim lightweight title shot against then featherweight champion Max Blessed Holloway. The fan favorites delivered a 5-round war in one of 2019's best fights of the year. Dustin outstruck Max in a 5-round war to get a decision victory and his first ever UFC belt. Unfortunately for Poirier, when he attempted to unify the belt to become the undisputed champ at UFC 242, he fell short against lightweight GOAT Khabib Nurmagomedov. Despite Poirier having a guillotine choke secured at one point in the fight, Khabib got out of it calmly and went on to submit the diamond in the 3rd round via rear naked choke. Dustin bounced back in 2020 with another fight of the year candidate against Dan Hooker, showing his experience to win the later rounds despite facing adversity early on. This fight did expose holes in Dustin's game. Had there been just a few more seconds at the end of the 2nd round, the New Zealand native could have finished Poirier in a huge upset. Dustin showed heart to come back and win the remaining 3 rounds, using his wrestling to his advantage and showing why he is a top contender. Next came the rematch with Conor McGregor at UFC 257. The Irishman started the fight off in an explosive manner as usual, landing more strikes than Dustin in the 1st round. However, Poirier utilized a tool we hadn't seen him use much, the calf kick. The repeated kicks to Conor's calf stifled him and made him stiff for a 2nd round. McGregor wasn't able to find his footing to throw powerful shots in the 2nd round, so Dustin started showing off his exquisite boxing skills, firing off beautiful combinations and earning the knockout in round 2. The rubber match that took place at UFC 264 really didn't settle anything between the two men. It was stopped because of Conor breaking his leg, but Dustin was dominating the 1st round, controlling Conor on the ground and landing powerful shots, besting him on the feet as well.
Who's boxing the bleeding head off him, kicking the bleeding leg off. Yous will show you do it to close the distance. This is not over.
The victory gave Dustin a shot at Charles Dubronx Oliveira's lightweight title, where Poirier won the 1st round, rocking Oliveira. The Brazilian somehow survived the onslaught and went on to use his incredible jiu-jitsu skills to earn a submission finish in the 3rd round. Dustin showed exceptional sportsmanship after defeat, offering to donate some money to Oliveira's hometown in Brazil. Both fighters come from rough backgrounds, and it is heartwarming to see how far they have come in the sport.
Fun fact,
Dustin Poirier was actually sent to juvenile detention as a teenager for getting into trouble in street fights, which was actually what paved the road to becoming a UFC fighter. After getting out of detention, Dustin chose to never attend school again, saying it felt like a prison to him. The Diamond then dedicated his time to perfecting his craft and becoming the best fighter he can be.
Attributes.
Both fighters are in the prime of their careers. Dustin is 32, while Nate is 4 years older at 36. When it comes to anthropometry, Diaz is the taller man at 6 foot. Dustin is 3 inches shorter at 5'9", and his reach is also 4 inches shorter at 72 inches compared to Nate's 76 inches.
Striking.
Both fighters are considered to be great boxers, so it's interesting to look at the stats, which are sure to be very indicative, considering both men have been in the UFC for a very long time. Dustin lands one more significant strike per minute, with his figure standing at 5.61 compared to Nate's 4.51. His strikes are also more accurate, coming in at 50% compared to Diaz's 45%. However, Diaz does take less damage, only absorbing 3.73 significant strikes per minute compared to Poirier's 4.28. Their significant strike defense is almost the same, standing at 52% and 53% respectively. When it comes to power, the numbers are quite frankly incomparable. Dustin has 15 KO TKOs to his name compared to Nate's lowly 4. From the stats, it is quite clear to see that Poirier has an edge in the striking department. We'll elaborate on that in the prediction segment, so stick around.
Grappling.
The grappling stats are very surprising. At first glance, you would expect Nate Diaz to have an overwhelming advantage in his department, but he actually doesn't. Poirier actually averages more takedowns per 15 minutes, standing at 1.44 compared to Nate's 1.1, with a higher accuracy as well, 36% compared to 30%. When it comes to takedown defense, Dustin's is up at 64% compared to Nate's 41%. Clearly, the Diamond has worked on this skill a lot to prevent more takedowns, but it's important to consider the fact that Nate doesn't mind going to the ground because of how much of a submission threat he is on the mat. When it comes to submissions, Diaz attempts 1.3 per 15 minutes, Dustin just behind him at 1.2. But the difference in completion is massive. Diaz has 15 subs to his name compared to Dustin's 6. The triangle, rear naked, and guillotine chokes are his go-tos. It's clear Diaz is more of a threat on the ground, but he doesn't have as much success at actually taking the fight to where he is more successful.
Prediction.
There are several scenarios that can take place in this fight. Poirier's has the advantage in the stand-up, besting great strikers like Max Holloway and Justin Gaethje. Diaz has been exposed with leg kicks in the past, like the Leon Edwards and Rafael Dos Anjos fights, and if Dustin is able to utilize his calf kicks as effectively as he did against Conor McGregor, he can find a lot of success. Diaz's boxing is on point, just like Poirier's. The question is the range at which the fight will take place. Poirier is at a reach disadvantage, meaning that he needs to close the distance and fight in the pocket with Diaz, utilizing his effective combinations. It helps that his hooks and uppercuts are vicious, meaning that if he gets close, despite Diaz's durability, he will be able to inflict some damage. One of Nate's best weapons is his chin, matched by his cardio. If fights were 10 rounds, Nate would be champion, gets thrown around quite a lot, and there's good reason for it. However, Dustin also showed that he is very durable in the Max Holloway and Dan Hooker fights, especially in the latter, coming back to win the late rounds after taking punishment early on. Nate definitely has an advantage on the ground. The BJJ black belt is a submission master, but unfortunately rarely takes it to the ground. If he were to improve on his wrestling, he would add a whole new arsenal to his game. But those changes aren't made overnight, and it definitely will not have improved enough since the Leon fight to be a real threat. If the fight does end up on the mat, though, be sure that Diaz will throw up all types of submissions in an attempt to finish the fight. The bookmakers currently favor Dustin Poirier at a whopping minus 400, with Diaz coming back as a heavy plus 300 underdog. Thank you guys so much for watching today's video. Who would you guys put your money on? Drop your fight predictions in the comments below and make sure to like and subscribe to never miss an Athlete Central video. Until next time.